Hi Hunters, in this video we'll continue talking about how you can expand malware analysis by browsing open directories with ANY.RUN sandbox. To start a new analysis, I paste a URL into the field and choose the Internet Explorer web browser. The browser is opening at the moment the task has been launched. As you can see, there are quite a few executables in this open directory and you can download all of them during one task. This time, we will investigate only one sample, but don't worry about struggles you may have with different processes or the possibility of getting an unclear result. With our service and the system tagging in the process tree, every malicious activity is tagged individually with the detected malware family name. So be brave to try them all. There's no risks for you. Let's randomly pick the R executable file and press the Run button. As we're acting like a typical layperson, let's ignore the security warning like real users would do and press Run again. In this case, the parent process of the launched executable file is Internet Explorer. If you look at the Internet Explorer process with ID 3768, you can notice the executable file was dropped indicator there. Well, we don't have to wait for long. As you may notice, an executable file has done a lot of things for a short time. It disabled the Windows Defender, changed the auto-run value in the registry, and wrote itself to the start menu. After that, it launched itself and created child processes. For a better understanding of what those processes have done in our system, let's take a closer look at their command lines by clicking on the process of interest. You can take a look at the command line in two ways, in the Process Details window, as well as in the Advanced Details of the process. By looking at the ID 2424 process, we may tell that this PowerShell process has added the main executable file at the Windows Defender's exclusion path so that it won't be checked later. Now let's close the Internet Explorer window so it won't distract us, and we're talking about malware behavior. From time to time, the detection of particular malware families may take time because crooks, by all means, try to prevent catching and exploring their products. In some cases, the reason may be deliberately delayed execution. Malware can put itself to sleep and wait for an indefinite amount of time. And you can't predict when it shows itself. As an example, to avoid detection in automated sandboxes, the infamous banking Trojan Drydex is often delaying execution using debug output messages. Meanwhile, our sample takes a network connection with a known threat that matches Agent Tesla's Suricata IDS signature. Let's open the advanced details of the RXE process. There you see that Agent Tesla is indeed detected by the network activity. On the right side, in the Events tab, we can see all the created files. Let's get back to the main window, look inside the Network block, and choose the Connections tab. As far as we know, Agent Tesla has been using SMTP's 587 port for a long time already. In most cases, it happens with broken encryption, so it sends the unencrypted information. We can take advantage of that flaw and look there inside Network Stream by clicking on the packet in the Traffic column from the Process of Interest. So, we can see what's exactly happening in our case. If you need it, it's possible to copy the authorization information from the network stream and try to log in using the attacker's account. In this way, we're able to see how many workstations have already been compromised, but we won't do that today. In this stream, you can see what information this Trojan steals from the infected machines. There are technical characteristics of a PC and all the credential data such as logins and passwords. And if it is available for crooks, it will become a critical situation. Let's stop our analysis and summarize that all. Using open directories is a kind of widespread practice for the distribution of malware throughout the world, and it's very important to identify such attacks and close holes in the defense in time. Because almost any person who is close to the malware creation could get access to stolen data. Thank you for staying with us to the end. You can check the tasks from the video in the description. I'd like to note that you have to be logged into the service to restart the submission and do analysis. We're always very excited to see your reactions to the content, so don't forget to share them with us. See you soon!